Emmanuel Kwabena, a data science and business analytics intern at the Spark Foundation, and we've been tasked to predict the optimum number of clusters of IRIS data sets and represent it visually. So I use a k-means model from sklearn, yes, which is a very good model to predict clusters or for unsupervised learning. So here I imported the necessary dependencies and I called up my data. So this IRIS data set including a categorical variable, yes. So here is a df.shape to check the number of rows and column. Df to describe in to check or to describe the categorical variable. That was just by the way, is not necessary needed. This one is needed. The df.describe here to describe the statistical analysis of the data set. So you can see the mean, the standard, and so on. And I wanted to check whether our data sets have some null values or zero values. And it says here that we don't have any null values, so I'm good to go. These two, I did this just by the way to check the IRIS data set, and I made some insights here. I realized that the sample length of IRIS data set is between 4 to 5 inches. 4 to 5 inches, yeah. Okay, so let's move on. And I made a scatter plot of the sample length and the sample width. And visually, from my perspective, I can see this. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4 groupings. Yes, that's what I see. Let's see what the machine model, the k-means model, will get. I got 4 clusters or groupings. 1, 2, 3, 4. So yeah, I made a variable for the numerical data set. And for the machine model to get the optimum number of classes, it uses what we call elbow method, elbow as in humans elbow, our elbow. So the SEC means sum of squared error. The elbow method is the theory behind the k-means. It draws our range of classes by our sum of squared error. Sum of squared error is just the error between the centroid and the... These are all theories. We'll get to it later on. So this is a process I used to get our sum of squared error. So this is supposed to be SSE. Sum of squared error. Then I plotted it this way. You see, this is our elbow method. And the elbow method, you see, it looks like a human hand. And here is the elbow of the human hand. So here is number 3. Our k-means model is trying to tell us that the optimum number of classes is 3. We use the elbow method to detect the optimal number. Here is the elbow. You see? So it made an array of 0 to 2, making it 3. Yes, so I plotted those array against our original data frame. Yes, and here is it. And I grouped the arrays into 3. For the classes which is equal to 0, I made a plot. For the classes which goes to 1, I made a plot. Of classes which goes to 2, I made a plot, a scatter plot. So you can see the groupings are 3, orange, blue, and green. And the purple stars are the centroids. The centroid determines the number of classes that belongs to it. Yes, so our machine learning predicted 3 models and I predicted 4 models. And you can see that the machine model is perfect, because when you check our data sets, if you check the species, it is 3. It has 3 models. all three groupings, sorry. Let me do some analysis here. I will see. You see, it has iris, setosa, vesicula, and which are three groupings. So our machine learning model also made three groupings, which makes it right. Therefore, the optimum number of classes is three. Thank you, viewers, for following along with me. Bye bye.